Welcome to General Admission News. Today, it's all about the U.S. men's national team. Their 26-man roster for two international friendlies in September is out today, and we're going to break it down for you. So let's start here. We're going to show you every player that got the call-up. We'll start with the goalkeepers. Of course, Zach Steffen is the one that we are most excited to see. Guzan there probably just for leadership, but Steffen is definitely the keeper of the future. And if you didn't see, he had an outrageous save for his club over the weekend. Definitely the most talented of the young keepers in the U.S. setup. Let's move to defenders next. John Brooks making his return, which we love to see. DeAndre Yedlin, I believe, still battling injury, so he's not in. But FC Dallas's Reggie Cannon is there. He had a fantastic performance, I thought, in the Gold Cup, really making up for Yedlin and Tyler Adams missing. By the way, Adams out as well. But everyone is most excited about Sergiño Dest from Ajax making his first appearance for the USMNT. The 18-year-old Dest is a mainstay in the U.S. U-20 system, and he played in the U-20 World Cup. Like I mentioned, he's over at Ajax. He's made 8 appearances for the U-20 setup in their World Cup cycle. People are just really excited about him, including Berhalter. So if you haven't seen him yet, definitely someone that you want to keep an eye on, just in terms of the U.S. will need some depth in the back line. I mean, they have John Brooks, who is an excellent center back. Outside of that, though, you have Yedlin, who hasn't really found his form yet. You have Reggie Cannon, who played well in the Gold Cup, but there's still questions about him. You have Tim Ream, who's on the older side. You have Walker Zimmerman, who, again, we don't know what we're going to see from him. Cameron Carter-Vickers, still not at the level that we'd like. A guy like Sergiño Dest could be exactly what the doctor ordered for the back line. And you can see that with 9 call-ups on the back line, most of any position group. You can see that Berhalter is going to be tweaking his lineup a lot. Let's move to midfielders next. 7 of them. Of course, the big name is Weston McKennie. McKennie's made 14 appearances for the national team, scored 3 goals, including in the Gold Cup. He's an excellent player. Keep an eye out on him, part of this young generation that people are so excited about, myself included. The big debutant here in the midfield group is Paxton Pomykal, the 19-year-old who also featured for the U.S. in the U-20 World Cup. And he actually tore it up in the qualifying tournaments for that World Cup. He helped the U.S. claim its second straight Confederation title. They scored 2 goals in that tournament final against Mexico, and Pomykal set up both of those, scored 3 goals and another 2 assists in that tournament, scoring in each of the U.S.'s first 3 games. So he's more of an advanced type of player, so it's going to be interesting to see how he works with Pulisic, assuming that Berhalter gets them both involved at the same time, if he chooses to do that. But if he wants to move Pomykal into more of a replacement type role for Weston McKennie, who himself would move to replace possibly Michael Bradley, who did not get the call up here, Berhalter might decide to go in that direction as well. McKennie, I think, is turning into more of your typical box-to-box midfielder, which I think could help. You wonder if there's going to be enough defensive help in the midfield. However, like I mentioned, Tyler Adams still hurt, so he did not get the call-up. He is certainly in the long-term plans, you would hope. If that's the case, he's a much more defensive-minded type midfielder. So if Berhalter is going to stay in that almost 5-back configuration, where Adams moves into the defensive midfield and then kind of drops onto the wing, or if he's going to move into a 4 in the back and then have a 3-man midfield with Adams, McKennie, and Pomykal, and then move Pulisic out to the wing, he could do that. But I think he might be moving a different direction altogether with the way that he wants to configure his attacking front line. And let's get to that. 6 forwards got the call-up. And I'm going to point out a couple here. Tyler Boyd, whom I really like playing for Beşiktaş in Turkey now. I like what he showed during the Gold Cup, even though he had only been an American as part of the American setup for a couple months, not even, by the time he got that call-up. Jordan Morris, who has only scored 5 goals as part of the U.S. setup, despite making 33 appearances. He's enjoyed a little bit of a resurgence at Sounders. But here's what I really like. Pulisic, obviously, is the future of the U.S. Josh Sargent getting the call-up. 7 appearances already at, I believe, just 19 years old. And again, he had an excellent U20 World Cup. Giassi Zardes from the Crew. No Jozy Altidore. Zardes is the only striker, the only true number 9 that got the call-up. Now, here's what I'm thinking. I mentioned that Berhalter now, if he wants to integrate Paxton Pomykal in the midfield, and if he doesn't, then this goes out the window. But let's assume that he wants to do that. If that's the case, then I think you're looking at a back 4, and you know, whoever that might be, if the center back pairing is John Brooks, Walker Zimmerman, whether it's maybe John Brooks and Matt Miazga or Cameron Carter-Vickers, whoever it is. If it's going to be a back 4 like that, then you have a midfield 4. You have Tyler Adams playing the number 6 role. Then you have McKinney and Pomykal, both of whom are kind of that box-to-box attacking option. And then you have Pulisic playing the 10, which Berhalter loves. Now that leaves you with a front 2. However, the U.S. doesn't have those fantastic strikers. You know, you have Giassi Zardes and Jozy Altidore, and Altidore, of course, drew a lot of criticism for that missed chance in the final of the Gold Cup. So I'm thinking more what the U.S. might transition to is having Tyler Boyd and probably Josh Sargent, maybe Tim Weah in the future, it just depends. There's options there. Having those two guys, and instead of playing them as 2 strikers, you actually play them as 2 wingers. So in reality, Pulisic becomes a false 9, and then you have the attacking options being, let's say in this case, it's Boyd and Sargent coming from the wing. Pulisic doing a lot of the creation, and then you have Pomykal and McKinney that are up there in attack as well. Now, to think about that, you're missing that real goal-scoring threat. What Jozy Altidore was at a time in his career for the USMNT, you're missing that. The thing is, you're missing that anyway. I don't know if Zardes brings that, at least not now. If he makes a massive jump, then we rethink. But he doesn't bring that right now. What you do have is Pulisic, who's made 31 appearances, scored 13 goals. He knows how to score. He has an eye for goal. We know that. So if he's the false 9, then possibly you have Pomykal and McKinney doing a lot of the creation, and you have Pulisic who just drops into space and then tries to make runs in behind as opposed to being your true number 9, if that's the way that you want to do it. Pulisic also, he likes to move out to the wing. It's where he's comfortable. So that's going to change the more that he gets experience. But if that's what he wants to do, then you have, let's say, Josh Sargent playing out there. Sargent tucks inside. He plays the number 9 in that configuration. He is a striker. He's played on the wing. I've seen him do both. So if you want to make him a wide striker, and then, again, like I say, have him tuck inside. If Pulisic moves out wide, you can do that. I think what's dangerous about that configuration, what the U.S. lacks in the air, meaning actually serving in crosses, is actually not a big problem. Christian Pulisic, in my mind, in the next 6 to 12 months, is going to establish himself as the best crosser of the ball in the world. And the reason why is not just because he's accurate with the crosses, but because he mixes them up so well, and he doesn't need his guys to beat people in the air to win his crosses. He can drive them on the ground, and he does that with such touch that guys, even who are shorter, can get on the end of him, or he plays them with such precise timing that you don't even really need to jump. It just kind of lands on your head when you're running towards goal. So I don't think that the lack of height would actually hurt the U.S. in that sense. But what they end up having is two midfielders that are used to playing box-to-box and even scoring when it comes to Pomacall, who, as I mentioned, scored three goals in the Confederation Cup in the U-20 buildup. And then you have Weston McKennie, who's already scored three goals in his 14 appearances with the U.S. Then you have, in this case, it would be Tyler Boyd, Josh Sargent, who have combined for four goals in their 13 appearances for the U.S. And then you have Pulisic, 13 goals in his 31 appearances. The more I talk about it, the more I believe that this might be the way to go for the U.S. as of right now, when they don't have a true target number nine. Zardes is not there yet. Altidore is past that point. I think this is the way to go for the U.S., but the only way that we're going to know is to watch their friendlies against Mexico and Uruguay in September, and we'll see how they come out. Berhalter could go with a back three, for all we know. There's going to be a lot of experimentation. But, big takeaway, I really like this roster. I think if you obviously add in Yedlin and Adams in the future, and then my hope is eventually Cameron Carter-Vickers and Tim Weah make their way in, you're probably looking at maybe the 2022 World Cup roster. Certainly, that's going to be your 2026 World Cup roster. I would almost certainly imagine that. So keep an eye on Dest, keep an eye on Pomacall, and let's see what they do with the lack of true number nines right now in the roster. Thanks for tuning in to GA Sports News. Subscribe for everything we've got coming out. We'll see you later.